Buenos dias, mi gente. Welcome to Monday Music Mantras, where we start off our week with music and a mantra that'll change that gloomy Monday morning frequency to an energized station. This is Maria Turk. So how was your week since last Monday? Were you able to feel good with those stress reducers on last week's video? Well, if you didn't catch it, remember to get caught up. Now, what about when stress hits the people we love? It's so hard for it to not affect our physical response to that stress too, right? Yeah, we wake up on a Monday morning worrying about other people's stressful situations. How do we distinguish between showing compassion and going through it with them? Yes, we spent most of this past year working on ourselves, on our baggage, those rocks we carry onto the dance floor. We're changing our stories, we're learning new moves, we're igniting our love superpower. We're in our happy place, and then boom, someone we love is hit hard with a terrible situation. Now what? Well, in full transparency, I'll confess that I physically react to other people's pain, even if it's fake, like in a movie. So when it's for real, yeah. Let me just say that I've come a long way from the days when I worked for a hospital and I thought that the doctors were so callous for feeling nothing when we'd see trauma patients coming in. I was a mess. I didn't even know these patients, but I was a mess. The doctors, well, good for them, but I misjudged them. They weren't being callous. They were in control of how their bodies would respond so that they could be strong enough to help their patients. And there's the beat. So let's break that down so that we can be our best for the people we love going through a mess. So feeling what others are going through, putting ourselves in their shoes, that's usually referred to as empathy. Yes, it's that ability to sense other people's emotions and imagine what they're thinking or feeling. Like Brene Brown would say, empathy is communicating that incredible healing message of you're not alone. But there are different types of empathy. One of them is cognitive empathy. That's simply understanding somebody's perspective. It's being an observation and understanding what they're going through. And because the understanding is in our heads, we respond with logic or information. That can be useful in certain situations like the doctors, but it's rarely effective when someone we love is suffering physically or emotionally. This cognitive empathy, we're not truly connecting with them with our hearts. Then there's emotional empathy. Whew. That's what I described before. That's going to the other end of the spectrum of actually feeling the pain the other person is feeling as if it's actually happening to us. Because it's extreme in its nature and opposite of cognitive empathy, there's no logic. It's not about thought or information. It's purely emotional. You feel it, so I feel it. You get hit on the head and my head whips back and feels the pain. No logic. But in less extreme situations, if someone cries at a wedding and it tugs at our heartstrings, there's nothing wrong with that, right? So it's not all bad. But the problem with this is if we don't have control of how it affects us, like we discussed in the last 3 weeks, too much is too much. We get overwhelmed and we end up suffering the effects of someone else's stress. How can we help them if we can't help ourselves? If we become weakened by their suffering? But here's the smooth rhythm we're looking for. The best we can do for those we love, it's called compassionate empathy. It includes intellect, emotion, and action. Yes, we have an understanding of their pain, we can feel their pain, and we're compelled to help if they need us. It's that balance that keeps us from getting overwhelmed. It's staying grounded in the logic of where the stress lives. We don't become the situation. No, we understand the situation with understanding. We also feel that pain and stress without it physiologically affecting our bodies, minds, and spirit, as we learned last week. Instead, we ignite our love superpower. Yes, we ignite our love superpower, WWLD. What would love do? What's the best way to help our loved one? With a supercharged superpower, our intellect and our understanding will help us do the right thing for them. Guess what? Sometimes getting out of the way helps them more. Let's not take it personally. Our love superpower will guide us to focus on what's best for them. Not what feels good for us to be able to say we did this or that to help them. Yes, let's let that love superpower and our compassion help us see how to best help those we love. It starts with not making it about us. It's not time to tell our life story or what we would do or making the situation personal as if it actually did happen to us. It didn't. Let's focus. It also means that we don't need to keep on rehashing on the woulda, coulda, shoulda, or trying to dig into the details that don't solve for anything. Yes, there are situations that digging into details do matter, but if they don't, then let's consider helping by improving their current state, since not much can be done with what already happened. And by improving their current state, sometimes getting someone whole again to where they were before whatever happened, well, that can be too much of an overwhelming leap. So instead of a leap, let's consider just one step. What's the next best step to make this better? Whether physically or emotionally, what would one step better look like? And when that step feels comfortable, what would the next step look like? And back to that overwhelming feeling again, remember last week about the most effective modifier to stress response, social support. Yes, we're in this together. It's not for one person or sometimes even just two people to solve. I'll repeat what I said last week. I said that isolation or feeling like we're all alone to deal with our stress, like there's nobody that understands us, this exasperates our stress. The burden of that stress is too heavy for any one person or even two people, and the body responds. Conversely, when we have a community of friends, spiritual connections, significant others, family, a strong network of supporters, cheerleaders, sponsors, mentors, coaches, and teams, we feel supported, we're balanced and energized. We can laugh, sing, and share. And that load that is too heavy for one person or two, wow, it's so much lighter with our people by our side. Here's the thing, when we feed these relationships, when we're there for them, the same circle or community is there for us too. We need each other to ignite our superpowers to make us all strong. Look, there's definitely not a one-size-fits-all for helping those we love who are suffering. So please share with me, share with the community, what else helps you show compassionate empathy so that you can stay strong enough to help and stay healthy? Please do share or send me a message. You've all been great support. So for this Monday Music Mantra, with compassion, we will remember. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. And maybe you're going to be the one that saves me. Yes, let's have a love-ignited Monday and remain compassionate the rest of the week. We got this together. Hit that like button if this resonates with you. Share with a friend or two or three. Subscribe if you haven't already and let me know how your week is going. Come back next Monday for another mantra to groove out your week. And until then, there are so many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. Maybe you're going to be the one that saves me. Check out this great cover, Stay on This Frequency, and stay in touch.
Today was gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now, they should have somehow realized what they gotta do. And I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. Baby, the word was on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. Should've somehow realized what you gotta do. roads that lead you there are winding, and all the lies we have to walk are binding. And there are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. Said maybe
with me.